Hi, so today I'm going to explain about my individual presentations of animal physiology about two questions. So the first question is, what is the physiology of oxygen and carbon dioxide? So before we answer that, we need to understand the concept and definition first. The physiology of oxygen and carbon dioxide is known as the gases exchange during cellular respiration process. And by meaning cellular respiration process is the cellular process of producing ATP, water, carbon dioxide from glucose and oxygen. So the gases exchange will occur in alveoli, so the oxygen will be loaded into the bloodstream and the carbon dioxide is unloaded from the bloodstream. And afterward, the oxygen will be brought to the left side of the heart via the pulmonary vein, which pumps into the via the systemic circulation. And the red blood cells that carry the oxygen into the capillaries of the tissue of the body, as the oxygen diffuses into the cell, and the carbon dioxide will diffuse out of the cell into the bloodstream. So, to picture the interpretation, the oxygen that any human or organism inhale will through the mouth and then goes to the lungs. So, these are the oxygen that goes from the alveoli to the blood capillary. So, and then the oxygen will be transferred to all parts of cells and tissues in the body. As vice versa, the carbon dioxide will be exhaled and be brought back to the alveoli as we exhale. So, the oxygen transport. The hemoglobin is the primary transport of oxygen. So, we need to know that in oxygen transport, there is about dissociation curve, where dissociation curve will show the amount of oxygen saturated in hemoglobin for a given partial pressure of oxygen, and the saturation of the oxygen in the hemoglobin is an indicator of how much oxygen are able to reach the tissue of the body. So the oxyhemoglobin dissociation curve can shift in response to many factors, and any change in the partial pressure of the oxygen, the P50 of the curve, is a sign that the dissociation curve has been shifted. The shift indicates a change in the affinity of the oxygen binding to the hemoglobin, which change the ability of the oxygen to bind to the hemoglobin or to stay bound to it. So these are the dissociation curve, where the y-axis shows the oxyhemoglobin saturations and the x-axis shows the partial pressure of the oxygen. So the higher partial pressure means higher saturation of the oxygen in blood, and the normal partial pressure is the P50. So the plateau of the partial pressure is P60, means the maximum point of the partial pressure. Anything that exceeds won't significantly increase the saturation, means the carrying capacity of oxygen in hemoglobin had been reached and any oxygen won't go into the hemoglobin. So if the curve shifts right, then the oxygen affinity for binding to hemoglobin is decreased. But if the shift left, when it's then it means the affinity for binding is increased. So these are the example. When the oxyhemoglobin reach a tissue where, because for example the skeletal muscle is an example of anaerobic, so when it has low partial pressure, it will dissociate the oxygen into hemoglobin, which results in higher local partial pressure. So for example, like low partial pressure will result in higher oxyhemoglobin pressure. But for the next example, if it reached in a tissue of high partial pressure, for example during pulmonary circulation, then the hemoglobin will continue to take up more oxygen, which will result lower partial pressure needed. So during pulmonary circulations, that the, for example, we give that it reached to P60, then there will be, or maybe P40, there will be less oxyhemoglobin needed. That's why it says it results in lower partial pressure. So for the carbon dioxide transport, where the carbon dioxide is the product of cellular respiration and is transported from the cell of the tissue in the body to the alveoli of the lungs through the bloodstream. And the carbon dioxide is carried in blood through three ways, which is first the dissolved gas, the dissolved carbon dioxide, second as bicarbonate ions, third as the carbaminohemoglobin. And the left side here is a diagram showing the gas exchange in a tissue. So the first here is the dissolved carbon dioxide. About 5% of carbon dioxide will be transferred to the plasma of the blood that unbound to anything. So we can see that the dissolved oxygen is not bound to any type of cell or any red blood cell. The second method is where the oxygen binds to the iron content in the heme of the hemoglobin, the carbon dioxide bind to the amino acid chains on hemoglobin where the carbon dioxide clings to hemoglobin. So the equation here is carbon dioxide clings to hemoglobin and form the carbaminohemoglobin. And this type of carbon dioxide exchange is about 10% transported to the human body. And the last transport is through carbon dioxide travels in bloodstream via bicarbonate ions. This occur about 85% during the gas exchange, where the carbon dioxide reacts with water to form carbonic acid, which dissociates in solution to form hydrogen ions and bicarbonate ions. So the carbon dioxide has implications, means the cons. So if any carbon dioxide increase in our body, it will manifest the increased concentrations of bicarbonate, which as well increase concentration of hydrogen, reduce the blood, our blood pH, and makes our blood become more acidic. And conversely, if the carbon dioxide level are reduced, there will be less bicarbonate and less hydrogen ion dissolved. So the pH will increase, but then it will become more basic. So the bicarbonate ions act as the buffer to the pH of the blood. So as long as both bicarbonate and hydrogen ions are balanced, then the pH blood will be in a neutral level. And any changes in carbon dioxide levels explain how ventilation rate and blood chemistry are related, such as the hyperventilation that may cause alkalosis and hypoventilation that will cause acidosis. So moving on to the next part, where we need to explain the differences between insect, fish, amphibians, reptiles, and mammals' respiratory system in terms of oxygen and carbon dioxide exchange. In this question, it will be explained via each of the organism. So